taboos. It's a funny word, but packs a lot of meaning. Most taboos make us experience a violent feeling of repulsion, but whether you like it or not, they do clue us into what we find acceptable. But I find myself asking, what are taboos and why are they so bad? Well, back in the heyday, society was run by religion. Pollution of the soul by hate and menace encouraged one to sin, violating the laws of God. As a result, an individual would take part in an action that is completely against Christian teachings and would thus mortally sin, or as we know it today, commit a taboo. We feel a sense of deep disgust when committing a taboo, because we transgress rules and laws that are fundamental to moral order. According to our old friend Google, morality can be defined as principles concerning the distinction between right or wrong, or good and bad behavior. However, our principles are influenced by how we are socialized by society and even our families. For instance, do you keep that $50 on the floor or do you hand it in to lost property? Hopefully, we would hand it in. Also, influencing our morals is the mother of principles, otherwise known as the law. The law keeps society in check, what is good and what is harmful to yourself and other people. This is where taboos come in. Taboos are social or religious customs prohibiting a particular practice or forbidding association with a particular person or thing. What do you immediately think of? I think of cannibalism, incest, pedophilia, and necrophilia. But for our sanity and stomach's sake, we will only talk about two of these, my choices being cannibalism and incest. Why? Because I'm a fan of Hannibal and Game of Thrones. We'll start with cannibalism. Gross, right? Well, to us, yes, but to people from other cultures, it's a spiritual process or part of a religious belief. We think that consuming human flesh is immoral. Yet, how about when people found out the survivors of the Uruguayan Air Force Flight 571 crash in the Andes had eventually resorted to eating the corpses of their dead comrades? Or how about the consumption of human placentas becoming the trend for urban sophisticates and ridiculously rich people? Do we consider this disgusting? From a cultural perspective, people who have been raised in Western country will be socialized to believe cannibalism is taboo and frankly gross, partly due to residing Christian values in our secular society. Humans are all equal in the eyes of God, so devaluing and objectifying one to become food is completely disrespectful and sinful as it undermines God's authority. Another thing to consider that in the slightly snobby Western imagination, cannibalism brings to mind primitive humans and barbarism, the amoral lifestyle that civilization tries to protect us from. The consumption of another individual is considered illegal even with consent because it is A, dehumanizing, and B, barbaric. Although we may be confined by society's rules and norms, the law is put in place to protect us from ourselves. Unlike cannibalism, incest is a universally acknowledged taboo. Why is that? Well, there is the obvious reason, the possibility of giving birth to unhealthy children. This is evident in the study of Czechoslovakian children whose fathers were first-degree relatives. More than half the children who were the product of the incestuous relationship were damaged. 42% of them were born with severe birth defects or suffered early death, and 11% were mildly mentally impaired. Well, okay, so there is a chance of your children coming out a bit strange, but like, is that all there is to this whole incest taboo? The simple answer is yes. Reproducing with a relative does not allow for genetic variation in offspring. With inbreeding, there is more chance of showing a recessive genetic trait due to both parents carrying very similar sets of DNA. If incest becomes a popular thing, then negative recessive traits would become more prominent, resulting in a large population of unhealthy offspring. From biological view, reproduction is the purpose of life, so if you give birth to children that are bound to die young or be damaged in some other way, then they will not live to carry on your genes. Simply put, you failed at living. Condemning incest is instinctive in all creatures, including us. I know this is a lot to take in, so let's do a recap. Our morals are influenced by the law, which is basically society's morals as a collective. These morals have a slight Christian taste to them, especially concerning cannibalism. Eating other people is naughty because we would be undermining God's authority by devaluing other people. We also think eating people is barbaric and we are way too advanced for that. Just in case we do ignore these principles, the law says no. As for incestuous relationships, there is a high chance of birth deformities for children. Thinking from a base perspective, carrying on one's genes and creating strong offspring is the purpose of life. In this case, incest is not wincest because you won't be winning at life if you ignore your animal instinct and decide your family is looking extra good tonight. So, what are taboos? they are the other of society. Why are they bad? Because we are socialized to believe they are.